Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, I'm going to talk about how you can turn any telescope, binoculars, or camera into a solar telescope, and you do that by using some solar safety film. This can be added to the front of any optical instrument, and you can actually buy it as a plain sheet of solar film, and then cut it to the size you want, and then mount it on the front. Always make sure you securely mount it, though. And before you use any solar film, you should always check that there are actually no holes in it. To do that, just look it up to a light source and make sure you can't see any light shining through. Once you have it on there, you can look through there with a camera or with your own eyes, and it will work perfectly fine. And you will be able to see like a white version of the sun. And there you can see what the sun looks like through the filter without anything else in the way. Okay, so the particular solar filter I've got here is the Eclipse Smart Celestron solar filter. And you can see I've securely attached it to the front here. And if you make your own solar filter, you also need to do the same. Now, before you start doing any kind of solar observing, you want to make sure that you cover up any of the like finder scopes or any other optical things you're not actually using. So this will stop any potentially magnified stray light going in your eyes. The most important thing when doing solar observing is at all times to be safe, to do nothing that could potentially damage your eyesight. So when you're trying to locate the sun in the sky, obviously you're not going to look for a finder scope because that'd be incredibly dangerous. So unless you've also got a solar filter on top of that. So what you can do is you can move the telescope like so, until its shadow is as small as possible. And once you've done this, you see the shadow back there? Once you've done this and the shadow is incredibly defined and as small as possible, you know you've actually got it pointing directly at the sun. Right, so let's get on and take some solar images. A white light filter reduces all wavelengths of light equally by about 99.999%. It's important to realize that if you have an aperture telescope larger than 6 inches, you can stop it down when creating your solar filter, as at this point, extra light is not required. This is usually done by using an off-axis solar filter. So, a solar filter film will show you details on the disk of the sun, which really only boils down to sunspots, which are cooler patches on the surface of the sun, which is why they appear dark, as shown in this image I took. You might also see faculae. These occur near sunspots and above the photosphere, and are best seen along the edge or limb of the sun, where the limb darkening helps to enhance their contrast. So what does this allow you to do? Well, you can match the progression of sunspots across the surface of the sun. You can capture transits of Venus or Mercury as they pass in front of the sun, as well as watch solar eclipses. If you want to see any other features such as the photosphere or solar flares, then you will need a hydrogen alpha telescope. Well, that's all for another episode. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you have any questions, then please do leave them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer them. If you liked the episode, then please give us a like. It really helps out the channel. And if you'd like to see more astronomy episodes, then please do subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.